thousands of people sending a message in downtown Pittsburgh today. They came out on both sides of a major issue affecting almost everybody in our area. The protest took place outside as people inside federal hearings told officials what they think about the new anti-pollution rules for power plants. Those rules would require Pennsylvania and other states to come up with plans to cut carbon emissions to reduce them by 30% nationwide. And from the impact on our jobs to your electric bill, the environment, a lot of people have a lot to say about this. Channel 11's Tamika Artis live downtown, sorting it all out for us. Tamika.
David, certainly is a volatile topic. There were thousands of protesters here today, a very, very large crowd, but I can say they were pretty much well contained. Now, supporters on both sides of the aisle, as you mentioned, they took to the streets of downtown Pittsburgh today. And if you happened to be anywhere near this area during lunchtime, then you know that it was quite a sight to see.
Chanting and waving signs, more than 10,000 strong.
I'm supporting my husband and all my friends.
Supporters and throngs of EMA workers lined the streets of downtown Pittsburgh to fight what they call the war on coal.
What are you hoping to accomplish?
We're here to make a stand and let them know we're not backing down.
The group representing coal miners and boiler makers marched from the convention center to the federal building as the EPA's air quality hearing entered day two. Angie Smith fears more government restrictions on carbon emissions could result in the loss of more than 65,000 jobs.
I believe in the coal industry. That is very important for us middle class folks.
The union masses were met by a much smaller group who say big business is being built at the expense of the environment.
They are taking advantage of the rest of America by trashing the country.
It's not a practice planet. It's not a dress rehearsal. We need to take the greatest care we can of this planet right now.
A handful of protesters were cited for disorderly conduct, but for the most part, lunchtime spectators say the crowds were well behaved.
It's cool. We can come out and speak our minds like this.
All right, well, I had a chance to speak with a former IUP professor who agrees with Mayor Peduto that both sides of this issue need to sit down and come together, yet he was arrested. I'll tell you what that was all about in my live report at 6 o'clock. Reporting live in downtown Pittsburgh, I'm Tamika Artis, Channel 11 News.
All right, Tamika, we'll see you then. Thank you. More details now. Leaders with the Consumer Energy Alliance say the regulations would cause a loss in jobs and a spike in energy prices. Senator Tim Sullivan said that two local coal-fired plants already had to shut down because of the regulations. Sullivan says it's easy for the EPA to pick on the plants because of their history with carbon emission. However, he said emissions have decreased more than 90% over the last 30 years. In the meantime, supporters of the proposed legislation and regulations also rallied this morning. Mayor Bill Peduto joined the health experts, labor and industry leaders, and environmental advocates at the August Wilson Center downtown. The mayor says the proposed carbon pollution standards give both Pittsburgh and the country an opportunity to move forward and create a system that will not only be long-term and sustainable, but also create more jobs. On the EPA's proposal to make energy producers in the U.S. cleaner, this is part of President Obama's bigger plan to cut carbon dioxide emissions by 30% by the year 2030. And for that to happen, fossil fuels like coal and oil would have to be used fewer and fewer in power plants. And that makes this a local issue because it will impact local jobs and local energy bills. As you can see by the numbers of protesters who turned out here in Pittsburgh today, this remains very controversial. And Channel 11's Tamika Artis live with why some people's passion over this topic led to arrest today. Tamika.
David, this is an issue that affects all of us, and it's gotten a lot quieter here in downtown Pittsburgh. But earlier, there were thousands upon thousands of people on these streets, but only a handful of people arrested for disorderly conduct. Today, I had a chance to meet a man who was arrested during a separate protest yesterday, and he says he agrees with Mayor Peduto that we have to find a way to have both sides come to the table on this very important global issue.
That was what I got arrested for yesterday.
Charles McAllister is passionate about jobs and the environment. He's one of a handful of lone protesters who'd like to see both sides come together. A former machinist and IUP professor was one of thousands who lined the streets of Pittsburgh today as workers representing the coal industry rallied during day two of the EPA hearings inside the federal building. On the other side are the environmentalists who say big business is killing our planet. McAllister, who was arrested during a workers' rights protest at UPMC yesterday, says what's needed is real change and for both sides to come to the table.
We all need to evolve to a cleaner and better world, but we got to protect workers' rights and we got to pay decent wages. And what's when you pit the two against each other, we're going to get neither.
Thank you. Welcome to Pittsburgh.
Mayor Peduto echoed those same sentiments when he addressed a crowd of union workers this morning. He says innovation is what leads to job creation.
We can create smart buildings that produce more energy than they use, delivery systems that don't rely upon an inefficient power grid, and use all types of sources in order to capture energy, not just fossil fuels.
Well, Mayor Peduto says he'd like to see the city of Pittsburgh become a world leader in creating efficient energy sources that also put people to work. It's being done in Europe and Asia. He says there's no reason it can't be done here in Pittsburgh. Reporting live in downtown Pittsburgh, I'm Tamika Artis, Channel 11 News.
All right, Tamika, thank you very much. More details now on other similar EPA meetings and protests happening around the country. This is video from Denver yesterday, where hundreds signed up to comment during the two-day event there. And you can see coal miners from western Colorado and neighboring states showed up to loudly voice their opposition. Channel 11 News will continue to monitor this big local story. So look for updates as they continue to come in both here on TV and online at our website, WPXI.com.